Hi guys, it's Miss T. I'm coming to you with my quickweave bob tutorial. I have washed and conditioned my hair. Believe it or not, my hair is 100% natural. What I did is I flat ironed it because trying to mold it with the gel and stuff, puffball, not cute. Not cute to have a quick weave that's puffed up off your head. but anyway, I'm getting ready to mold my hair. I will be using, where is my gel? Anyway, I'll be using Vitel high protein styling gel, as well as the Grow Protect solution. I don't know if you guys can see that. Morning Glory products. MorningGlory.com. MorningGloryProducts.com to order this. It's not just sold to professional stylists. So I'll be back with you guys in a little while to show you how my hair is molded. Hey guys, I'm back. I have my hair molded. I know you're like, well, what is this little piece sticking up? It's just where I molded it and it didn't lay as flat, but I'll put a bobby pin in that and it'll be alright. But I did a simple ponytail mold, just pulled my hair back in the ponytail, put gel on it, set up under the dryer, then I used the Grow Protect solution, ice clear, and set back up under the dryer for maybe another 10 or 15 minutes. This is what it looks like. It dries very shiny. Kinda has a plastic feel to it. I'll turn around and show you guys the back. When I turn around in the back, it's gonna have the, it's gonna look white. Because I put it down a little bit on my neck because my hair grows very far down. So this is what it looks like in the back. And I will get back with you guys shortly after I've placed a few tracks in to show you how I do my track placement. Okay guys, I'm back. I have placed maybe 3 or 4 tracks in the back, just from ear to ear. I'll turn around so you guys can see that. From one point of my ear to the other point of my ear. Behind my ear, not from ear to, well, yes, the same thing, ear to ear. What I'm getting ready to do now is go from temple to temple, and I'll do that till I get about here. And when I get here, what I'll do is begin to lay the tracks at an angle going back until I close to create the effect of a part. Of course, it won't be an actual part, but just to give me that look so that the hair will fall that way over my eye and I won't have to cut in a bang or have to comb the hair over. I hate to see a quick weave that was done in a circle at the top and then you have to comb the hair over and you see that tracks this light. It looks, I don't like it, but you know, to each his own. I'll be back with you guys shortly to show you my progress. Okay guys, I'm back again, but I'm not at the point where I'm getting ready to start placing my tracks. That's nasty. Placing my tracks forward. I have about 2 more tracks that I want to do before I start doing that. What I did want to show you is the brand of hair that I'm using, and the color, and also to show you how I go about purchasing my hair. What I've used is Claire Yaki. It is by Model. This is a 10 inch, I don't know if you guys can see that, but it is a 10-inch. This is the girl on the package. It is a jet black. Also, how I go about purchasing my hair. This hair was $9.99. But what I do, I usually don't buy cheap hair, but I never keep a hairstyle for more than a week. So I figure, why keep spending a whole lot of money on expensive hair and leave it in for a week? So anyway, how I go about purchasing my hair is, what I do is I get it, and if it moves in the pack, then that's a plus. When I inside of the actual package, not, you know, but what I do is, if it moves in a pack, then I'll say, let me see. What I do then is I take it out of the pack, make sure that it moves, it's not stiff, it continues to move even after I stop shaking it, that's a plus. Then the next thing I do is I take and run my fingers through it, and if more than one or two hairs come out, then I won't purchase it. But if only a couple of hairs come out, no more than 5 hairs, then I'll say, okay, I'll get that hair. So as far as my little test for purchasing hair goes, this was a good brand. So I'm gonna try it out. I'm gonna see. This is my first time using it. I'll let you guys know how it works. Okay, so I'm back. I have completed my trekking process with the horseshoes from ear to ear, temple to temple. I came around a little bit here to the front of my, as I said earlier, cow lick. And what I'm about to do now is begin placing the tracks at an angle so that when I finish, it'll have the effect of a part. Like I said earlier, I'll be placing all of them at an angle this way and then coming around. And as I said earlier, it's not going to be an actual part, of course, because my hair is not parted, but that's what I'm about to do. I will get back with you when I get to the closure piece. Okay, I have completed my gluing process. All tracks are placed. I have my closure piece. I did a regular closure. And I guess I was saying a part earlier, but I guess I meant it looks more like a wrap style, like if you just wrapped your hair instead of taking a quick weave and combing it over, and it looks kind of, you can kind of see where the tracks are. But I'm getting ready to cut and style, and I'll show you guys how I cut it, because I don't cut my bobs like, well, I'm sure somebody else has done this before, but I'm just gonna pull it back in the ponytail and cut it so it'll file like a stack bob. Then I'll go back in and put some layers in it, but I'll show you guys that. Be back in a sec. Okay, I'll put my hair in the ponytail, and what I'm gonna do is I'm just cut straight down. That's the effect that it gives me, and I know I'm gonna have to straighten it up and all of that good stuff, but that's the effect that I was going for. So I'll show you the finished product when I'm finished.